Good afternoon, Minglaba. First of all, it's my great honor to be invited as a speaker to this wonderful conference in the beautiful city. Thanks to our educational program from 2011, I had a chance to make good friends from Myanmar, including Dr. Tang Lui, Dr. Tun Tun, and so many other doctors. It is very pleased to meet all of them through the long tunnel of the COVID. As we know well, the surgery is the curative treatment, any kind of malignant tumor. However, many more patients cannot be resected, so in that case, local regional treatment is a good alternative, including ablation and TACE and TARE and radiation therapy. So today I'd like to really be focused on tumor ablation. The cancer can be developed in any organ, among them the liver, lung, kidney, and musculoskeletal system, and thyroid, and uterus is the most good candidate for local ablation. What about the ablation source? From thermal ablation and chemical ablation, and also we can use the ultrasound as energy modality. I think the mission of ablation is very similar to the postman, to deliver the right energy to the right place in the right time. This is a really basic for successful ablation. Today, I'd like to try answer to these three days questions. First, where are you now? Second, what still matter? Third, what comes next? Shall we start with the first question? Where are we now? In other words, what is the current location of ablation in the treatment of HCC? Before starting for first question, I'd like to say we may know that Asia is the real birthplace of local regional treatment, including external injection, transarterial chemoembolization, and microwave ablation. We should be proud of it. Thanks to the many papers by Asian Society of Chemoablation Group, according to the recent Dr. Liang's review papers, almost half of literature on tumor ablation was published from Asian countries, including China, Japan, and Korea. This is a two landmark paper from Japan and Korea, local ablation for early stage HCC with more than 1,000 patients. As you can see, 5-year survival rate is more than 60%. 10 years ago result, but quite surprising compared to the surgical resection. And this is the recent update of our data. As you can see, 10 years overall survival for early stage HCC, 74%. That means during 10 years, there are a lot of technical advancement. That's why the outcome is continuously increasing. Surgery versus ablation, really long-standing question, debate. But I think everybody in this room maybe agree with this summary. Regarding local tumor control, surgery is definitely better, but overall survival, quite similar for smaller than 3 cm tumor. About the effectiveness, definitely ablation is much cheaper than surgical resection and transplantation. This is the recent famous randomized control trial from Japan, so-called SURF study. Japanese researchers in 89 institutions compared the outcomes of surgery and ablation. As you can see, there was no difference in even recurrence-free survival between surgical resection and ablation group. After this study, we can say ablation can be considered first, even if surgically resected. What about in treatment guidelines? Liver transplantation, resection, and ablation are the treatment of choice when available and feasible because of curative potential. And in many HCC treatment guidelines, as you can see, ablation is recommended as one of the curative treatment options for very early and early stage HCC. Recently, Korean Liver Cancer Association and National Cancer Center also revised our treatment guideline. The Korean guideline also, ablation is definitely clearly recommended as one of the curative treatment options for early stage HCC, supported by level A evidence. What about the BCLC guideline? This recent version, 2022, you can see ablation finally survived as a curative treatment option. So in summary, the first question, where are we now? I would say we are in the old treatment guideline based on the evidence made by Asian researchers. But let's move on to the second question. What's the matter? Ablation is really perfect. I don't think we still suffer from size, location, and tumor biology. So let me check one by one. What about size? If tumor size is too big or too small, it is hard to ablate. Thanks to the recent advancement of imaging technology, this is the tumor size in our center. The average size is about 1 centimeter. That means technically very difficult. But we have many solutions, including fusion imaging and artificial fluid and contrast and sort of sound. And also we can combine transarterial chemoembolization. So we have many good friends to support successful ablation. Location is a really essential factor for successful ablation, including subcapsular, perivascular, and peri-organ tumor. So let me check one by one. For subcapsular tumor, it's a very sticky location. However, as you can see, the recent literatures demonstrated that there is no significant difference in the outcomes according to the location, because we understand the technical difficulty for 20 years, and we can apply many assistant techniques, and also we can modify. What about the subcapsular tumor? Recently, we don't use single electrode for subcapsular tumor. We used 2 electrodes at least to make circumferential ablation margin. What about perivascular tumor? Very sticky tumor because of the heat sink effect and complications of vascular complications. Very sticky condition. However, we also have many technical solutions to overcome heat sink effect. We can use microwave ablation rather than radio frequency ablation. And also we can combine 2 or 3 electrodes. And sometimes we can combine conventional TACE or ethanol ablation for perivascular tumor. So 10 years ago, perivascular tumor is a relative contraindication, but recently we don't think perivascular tumor, not just contraindication for ablation. What about the peri-organ? Very difficult, very important to avoid thermal injury, diaphragm, bowel, gallbladder, bile duct, peritoneum. However, we have artificial fluid to protect thermal ablation, including fusion, artificial fluid, and contrast and ultrasound. Assist ablation is a good solution for peri-organ tumor. Let me introduce my 2 cases with video. Okay, for making the artificial circuits, we use the angel catheter sheath, 5 French angel. The lesion is very thin on ultrasound. So this is how to insert angiography sheath, the narrow perihepatic space, using ultrasound guidance. After skin anesthesia, like that. I instruct the patient to inspirate. At that time, liver is already down on the displacement. At that point, I insert a sheath needle, just a subcapsular area, 1 centimeter. After that, I instruct the patient full exploration. At that point, the tip of ships almost always placed the California space. At that point, I insert the guide wire and replace engine weapon to the ships. If there is any IR, maybe you can easily understand. Okay. So change the 5-inch angiography sheath. After remove the sheath, you can find the sheath to carry a particular space and also artificial settings going into the subcapsular portion. Just 1 minute later, we can see the clear sonic window. Okay, compared without artificial sound. You can see the very tiny tumor, 8 millimeter tumor, and insert microwave antenna. Okay, here is tumor. To make sure, sometimes we use contrast lens ultrasound again, and you can see the hypovascular metastatic lesion exactly inside the yellow line. That means a tumor. Red line means our purpose target of ablation zone. That means including ablation zone, less about 1 centimeter. Okay, start the ablation. You can see a lot of microbubble. The microbubble is approaching the red line. That means we already cooked the tumor itself as well as covered the normal liver. 1 centimeter. This is our strategy for complete ablation. Even compared to the laparoscopy ablation, this is really minimal invasive. Only one band is enough. The second case, if the liver lesion is located in segment 7, bare area, artificial ascites does not work. So in that case, we are using the artificial pleural effusion to move up the long parenchyma. For artificial pleural effusion, we are using the epidural needle toward the costofrenic angle. As you can see, the sonic window is much improved, and we ablate it from deep position tumor, and then move the superficial portion with the 3 electrodes together. So after the ablation, you can see the very nice ablation tumor. So there are so many solutions to protect the tumor aborted organ. Okay, finally the biology still matter. If the tumor has a high tumor marker and micro-invasion finding on MR imaging study or MRM type, at that time the possibility becomes very high. So just a simple ablation is not enough. So in this case, we have to consider more aggressive strategies, not just a simple ablation. This is our study. This kind of microvascular invasion finding tumor shows a worse the frequent recurrence after the ablation. This is also MRM feature tumor, shows a bad worse local tumor control rate. So if the tumor shows this kind of feature, we don't do just a simple ablation. We combine TACE or we use microwave ablation. Microwave ablation is already replaced the radio frequency ablation in Western country, but in Korea, still radio frequency ablation is dominant because there are 2 very smart RF devices made in Korea. As you can see, the microwave is definitely stronger than radio frequency ablation. One of my friends, Fred Lee, 10 years ago, he told me, "Oh, sorry, Professor, RF is almost done." At that time, not yet my answer. But 10 years later, still my answer is same. Because there is no insufficient data, microwave ablation shows a significant survival benefit compared to RF ablation, even the randomized control trial. Thanks to the many Korean researchers, we supported no-touch technique using the two or three RF connectors together. This is a lot of advantage to make sure ablative margin more effectively, just a strong single weapon, okay? So this is our study. The local occurrence rate is really excellent, which is really compatible to the best result of microwave ablation so far. So if you have a chance, you can use multiple RF electrodes. There's a lot of advantage. I don't say RFA is better than microwave ablation. Depending on tumor characteristics, you can choose the wise weapon. This is our Korean guideline. You can find in KJL. Okay, what about the current solution for aggressive biology? We can use surgical resection, it's definitely better, and multiple no-touch ablation, and also combined with TACE. That can be a solution for tumor with aggressive biology. Okay, RFA still matter for regarding tumor size and location and biology, but as I mentioned here, we have a many solution, technical assistance to overcome this kind of barrier. Assistance software, there are many kinds of guidance software and assessment software. This is very looks fancy, but this software is not so much popular than we expected. On the paper is very useful, but impractical. So very minimal person I use this software. And also most software is CT guided ablation. What about cryoablation and ILA? It is a really promising new energy source, but cryoablation requires a much longer ablation time. ILA is still much, much expensive than thermal ablation. The new energy is a histostrip seat. Recently, one device is available on the market, actually under clinical study. So this is a much better than conventional HIFU technology. Maybe you can see in this technique maybe in 2 or 3 years. And finally, we are already living the era of immunotherapy. So what is the role of ablation in the era of immunotherapy? Already there are many basic studies, immune response after local regional treatment. But clinical data is insufficient. And also there are so many clinical trials regarding local regional treatment with immunotherapy. And also there are so many studies also performing regarding adjuvant immunotherapy after local regional treatment. So we have to wait for the reliable result. If validated, these treatment schemes will need adequate patient selection in order to maximize research. Anyway, we have to wait a couple of years to taste the real nice wine from this many kinds of wine batter. Okay, for 30 years, we have been too local, inertly local. So it's time to move from local towards more precise and optimal and liver-conserving ablation and also immunoablation. So I talk today that what's new in 2022 regarding liver ablation. As we all know well, the novel is beautiful like this, brother. But please remember the root. Basic beyond the novel. The basic is more important than just novel. From careful selection to learn from each case. Okay, let me summarize my talk. Okay, ablation is a curative for small HCC in most HCC treatment guidelines. novel techniques are necessary for better outcomes. However, basic principles should be essential. Okay, thank you for your attention.